Honorable Speaker, sir. Sir, I rise to participate in this bill to provide for establishment of private universities in the state of Telangana, sir. Honorable Speaker, sir, first and foremost, sir, I would like to come on record and say that it is a responsibility of the government to provide quality education, and at the same time, it's the responsibility of the government to see that the universities grow and we become so competent that we compete with the global world and also make a mark of our own. It has been a very sad state as far as education is concerned in the last 70 years. What we had seen is that, like in my generation, I take pride in saying that I have studied in so-and-so private school, where I have done my education in this private institute. But when we go back, a generation ahead before us, they used to take pride in saying that they have studied in a government school. Like I remember, my father used to always say that I have studied in Madrasa-e-Aliya. And Madrasa-e-Aliya was supposed to be the premier institute and the school of Hyderabad, not only Hyderabad, but the state. With time, sir, the government schools, the government colleges have lost their charm, and private schools, private colleges have come into existence, and private schools and colleges has taken away all the charm, and the elite schools and colleges have lost their charm. Why is the question mark? So when we have this question, I would say that the successive governments have been responsible for not taking care of these schools and these colleges. And that is why I would say the mushrooming of private colleges, private schools have come into existence, and they have really captured the education system of not only our state, but the entire country. And now, universities are also coming up. I'm not opposing this bill. Everybody has the right, and as well, the students also has the right to choose as to where to study and what to study. They can opt for a private, they can opt for a government, they can go for any aided or unaided, it is their wish. But at the same time, I would like to caution the government and say that, kindly make sure that the government institutes, whether schools or colleges or universities, do not lose their charm. Like if we have to go into the details, without going into the details, Honorable Speaker, sir, I can come on record and say that more than 1,200 posts are vacant in the state of Telangana in all the universities. Why is this situation? When the posts are going to be vacant, the university is going to lose its charm, the university will lose its status, university will lose its reputation because of the vacant post. When the government is going to ignore the government institutes, the government universities, the government schools and the colleges, it would be obvious that the student will opt for a private, where all the posts are there, where the best of the lecturers are there, where the best of facilities are there. So the government should take care. Like I would like to give a small example. Residential schools. Yes, I welcome this move. It's a very good move. Residential schools have come into existence. SC, ST, BCs and minority students are getting an opportunity to stay, have food, study, getting clothes, books, everything. I welcome this. But at the same time, my concern is, what is the fate of the government schools? If I am wrong, I may be corrected. The education department doesn't have money to even do a whitewash. They do not have sufficient amount to construct the toilets. They do not have amount to pay the electricity bills. So if this is going to be the state of schools, I would love to send my child to a government school, provided all the facilities are there in that school. But now what is happening? We do not have facilities in the schools, and I am forced to opt for a private school. So now this university bill has come up. I would like to caution the government and say that you should make sure that the existing government universities are not affected by these private universities. We need to take a care for these universities also, sir. Sir, at the same time, sir, when I speak on this bill, sir, so university means a private university establishment under Section 3 of this Act. Sir, I would suggest that Chapter 2. But sir, it is also necessary that this house knows an announcement needs to be made in this house. Okay, the bill is introduced. Any amendments would be received till so and so time.
It is announced.
Sir, I was not there, and it was told that the announcement has already been made. Sir, but that is why, sir, I am requesting you for an amendment. When we talk about universities, sir, universities need to be to be categorized or to be differentiated, sir. We are just saying that okay, it is a classified as just a private university. Sir, my request for an official amendment providing for classification of the private university in term of non-minority, minority under Article 30 of the Constitution. Why do I say this, sir? Sir, when we are saying private universities, do kism ki hote hain, sir. Ek minority hoti hai aur ek dusri non-minority. Minority mein do hoti hain, sir. One is religious minority, the second is a linguistic minority. So I request through you to the government and Honorable Minister for Education, the Honorable Deputy Chief Minister Saab, Mr. Kadiyam Hari Saab, to kindly have this official amendment. Have this official amendment for minority, religious minority, linguistic minority. Sir, for this purpose in Chapter 2, Establishment of University, Section 3 of the Bill, an official amendment shall be brought in by including a subsection to define the status of university as follows. The university so established be classified as non-minority or minority and further sub-classified as established for religious minority or linguistic minority under Article 30 of Constitution, sir. This is a very important, sir. Aur sab log jante hain ki ye hukumat akhliyat dost hukumat hai, minority friendly hukumat hai. When I rise to speak on this bill, I would like to assure that I am going to lend my support for this bill. But I request the Minister Saab to kindly have this amendment. Minorities laiye isme, koi farak nahi padega. Aate hain to aane dijiye. Lekin, sir, at the same time, I would like to recall and remind to this August House when in erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, sir, that time also I had raised an objection. Indian School of Business Management, they had allotted land. They had allotted land. But what is the share of the students in ISB of the state of Telangana and the Hyderabad city? There is no, but I welcome in this bill, it has been said that 25% would be made compulsory for the students of Telangana. Yes, it is good. And I would say that you need to enhance that more. At the same time, one question arises is that what would be the fate of SC, STs and BCs? Are we going to provide any reservation or any quota in this private universities? Private universities of non-minorities. Non-minorities, I am saying. As far as minorities are concerned in minority institutions, there is no reservation. But in non-minority universities, are you going to see that the interest of SCs, STs and BCs are going to be protected? Let us not forget, the state of Telangana has the majority of backward classes, the SCs and STs and the minorities. If you have to bring together the SC, ST, BCs and minorities, I am sure that they would constitute to 80% of the state population. So we need to address their issues also. I don't know what the government plans and how do they plan. And when I say this, sir, the universities so established shall be classified as for non-minority and minority and sub-classified as established for religious minority and linguistic minority under Article 30 of Constitution. I'm repeating this. Sir, further, I suggest that an amendment be brought in Chapter 4, Authorities of Universities, Section 20, Subsection 1, relating to government body of the university. Section 20(1) says, the governing body of universities shall consist of at least 6 members, including following members, namely the Chancellor, the Vice Chancellor, member to be nominated by the sponsoring body, officer not below the rank of secretary to the government of Telangana to be nominated by the government. Sir, I would suggest that an amendment be brought in Section 20, Subsection 1(D) as follows. Officer not below the rank of secretary to the government of Telangana to be nominated by government only in case of non-minority in universities. Now the question that would arise is, why is Owaisi just saying about in case of non-minorities? Sir, when I say this because the Honorable Supreme Court of India in TMA Pai Foundation and other versus State of Karnataka and others in authority and legal yardstick to be guided by one and all matter, here it stated that, sir, about minority educational rights, many questions were answered in this Honorable Supreme Court's judgment, sir. Sir, in this, sir, Honorable Supreme Court, while answering question 5(C) in TMA Pai Foundation case, has already said, rational procedures for the selection of teaching staff and taking disciplinary action has to be evolved by the management itself. So this means that the right to manage or administer the institute, the right is with the management. So this is why I am saying that, okay, this should be amended. And the reason for me saying is that, sir, this question has already been answered by Honorable Supreme Court, sir. Sir, when I say this, at the same time, I would like to take an opportunity and say that many and said that any staff engineering or any pharmacy college or architecture college, they have to have a nominee of government in the selection committee. Well, it is not necessary as per this judgment. When there is a Supreme Court judgment is there, wherein the management has its own selection committee and select its own faculty, there is no necessity for an outsider or a government nominee to be part of selection committee. So this needs to be understood, this needs to be addressed, and they are being harassed, sir. And at the same time, sir, I would like to take an opportunity by addressing one more serious issue which needs to be addressed by the government, sir, and that is about the degree colleges, sir. So the Honorable Supreme Court of India has provided and desired that the admissions to professional institute, either minority or non-minority, be only on basis of merit. Yes, professional courses
only on merit. Sir, and it also said that they should have a centralized test for which NIT has come into existence. Through NIT, they are selecting the candidates in professional courses, sir. But for non-professional institute, a question number 4 was asked in the Honorable Supreme Court, and the answer for that, therefore, the Honorable Supreme Court in TMA Pai Foundation case has clearly said that non-professional institutes, degree colleges, extra, etc., are like schools where the question of merit does not arise to the court of Honorable Supreme Court. The schools and undergraduate colleges where the scope for merit-based selection is practically nil cannot be regulated with concern of state or universities. This is what the Honorable Supreme Court has said. So through you, I would like to bring to the notice of Honorable Minister, who is a very learned man. So there is a judgment. A question has been answered about professional and non-professional. But now, minority degree colleges, they go to the court, which would be offered, which would come under the guidelines of AICT and the Medical Council of India or the Pharmacy Council of India, or they are going to come under the guidelines of the Cambridge, Harvard or Oxford, is the question which needs to be answered. Because what happens is that, sir, okay, they open a university and they have an affiliation with other foreign universities, and after having an affiliation with the foreign universities, they offer courses and they collect huge amount of fees. And when they collect, they say that, okay, we are autonomous, we are not affiliated with AICT, we are not affiliated with Pharmacy Council, we are not affiliated with Architecture, we are not affiliated with Medical Council. Nobody can question us. So now my last question through you to the Honorable Minister Saab is that if a university is allowed and they want to have a medical education, and if they have a tie-up with Oxford or Harvard, and they have a branch here in Hyderabad or in Telangana, so that medical education will come under the screening of Medical Council regulation, or will it come under the screening of the university, foreign university? These are the questions which needs to be answered. I know that, okay, when I was going through the Andhra Pradesh, this private university's bill, sir, the Telangana private university's bill also is exactly the same, sir. Urdu mein bolte hain, makhi to makhi bolte hain, sir. Bilkul makhi to makhi, wahan jo likha hua tha, yahan bhi wahi likha hua hai. Main ummeed karta hoon ki minister sahab mere uthaye gaye sawalat ka jawab denge, aur main minister sahab se phir se aapke zariye ye darkhwast karunga ki maine jo amendment laya hai ke liye pucha hai, official amendment ke liye, universities laiye zarur, laiye barabar, hum iske mukhalif nahi hai. Quality education hona chahiye, global competition mein hum bhi aana chahiye, hum barabar istiqbal karte hain, lekin in universities mein private daliye, oblique minority, oblique non-minority bhi daliye, aur ye dalkar jo selection ka jo ek jo committee hai aur ek secretary level ka ek officer minority mein rehne ki jo baat kar rahe hain, isko isme se nikalenge aap to aur acha hoga, minority universities bhi aayenge. Aur mujhe ummeed hai ki maine jo amendments ki jo darkhwast pesh ki hai aapke zariye hukumat ke samne, agar is par gaur kar positively lekar agar ye amendments ko accept karenge, to main samajhta hu ki riyasat Telangana ek nayi tareekh banayega, nayi history banayega, aur sare Hindustan ko ye paigham dega ki ye riyasat ne aaj private universities mein minorities ko bhi aane ke liye #minority universities ka bhi elan kiya.